our today's point is related to the next port, that is port 1, and port 1 is used as either input port, output port. And if we considering the features or peripherals of an port 1, the port 1 consists only IO operations. The alternate pin functions are not provided to the port 1. So if we see the connection diagram or internal structure of an port 1 is as shown in diagram, that is on screen, a latch, that is flip-flop, is there. Along with that, one FET is there at the lower end, and at upper side internal pull-up resistor. Here load 1, that is L1, is nothing but your pull-up resistors connected internally with the port pins of an port 1, where in case of port 0, two FETs are there, upper FET and lower FET, M1 and M2. But in that case, that is port 0, internal pull-up resistor is not provided or available in manufacturing or in architecture. That's why we need to interface external pull-up resistors while using port 0 as an output port. So in case of port 1, the pull-up resistor is already inbuilt in the structure of an port pin. So in this structure, one FET at lower side and at the divider circuit upper side is having the internal pull-up resistor. And as we have seen that whenever we want to use a particular port or port pin as an input pin, in that case it is necessary to make that particular pin or declare that particular pin initially high, so that further operations we will consider the given pin or given port will be acts as an input port or input pin. Or if we want to use the given port or that specific port as an output port or pin as an output pin, in that case it should mention earlier or initially that that pin is equal to 0 or 0 low, logic low, or 0 volt is applied to that particular pin or port, so that we will analyze that in further operations that particular port acts as a output port. So this is initial setting. After that is after declaring the given port or specific port which we are going to use as an input, as an output. So this is initial setting, we say that initial setting. So after initial setting, if we want to use the port 1, in this our case port 1, as an input port, in that case, so as shown in diagram, if we make internal bus is 1, it is indicated in blue color, blue box 1. So output of latch, that is D flip flop, becomes 1, and its complement, that is Q bar, becomes 0. So whenever we apply Q bar 0 signal to the lower FET, in that case lower FET becomes turns off, that is it will remain in off state. So it will not connected with the actual pin, that is P1.x, we consider P1.0. And here internal pull-up resistor is also there. Due to that, direct VCC is not provided in this case. So here if we make the input pin, in that case we should make read buffer active, or we should activate read buffer, that is at the bottom side here, read buffer. So if we activate this pin here mentioned active, so this path for the port pin provides an low resistance path. So if you are knowing the basics related to the circuits, current will always flow with the low resistance path. So due to this property, the signal, whatever signal is available at the port pin, it will move towards that read buffer, and through read buffer it will moving towards the internal bus. So signal moving like this. Here after voltage dropout, after the internal pull up, some voltage is there, but here due to that internal pull up resistors, it will never go in upward direction. So it will moving in this direction. And also here upper side VCC is having more power as compared to the signal available at the P1.0. That's why the signal available at P1.0, either 0 or 1, whatever signal is there, it will simply follows the path related to the read buffer where it is activated, and after that it will moving towards the internal bus, and through internal bus it will move towards the CPU. Okay, so this path will be followed when we use port 1 as an input. So conditions are that initially you make high to the internal bus. Due to this, it will generate one signal at Q, generate zero signal at Q bar. Due to this, your lower FET turns off, and due to this internal pull-up resistors, whatever signal is available, it will follow the low resistance path by activation of read buffer. Okay, and due to this, it will follow towards the input side of an CPU. So this is related to the input function of an port 1. And in this case, necessary thing is that you should activate the read buffer here so that we are able to access or fetch the contents towards the internal bus, that is internal CPU bus. And if we are considering the second case, that is when we are going to use port 1 as an output port. So in case of input port, it is not necessary that you should analyze what contents, that is either 0 or 1, is available on port pin, which will be fed to the CPU. So whatever signal is there, either 0 or either 1, if 1 is there, it will directly considered as a 1, but that is here received signal is 5 volt, so no problem. But if it is signal received is having the capacity of 0 volt, that is low signal is there, so CPU simply analyze that 0 signal is received as an input signal. Whatever the conditions are there, so it will consider as 0 signal. So this is the case where we did not need to recognize whether 1 is there or 0 is there. Whatever the signal available as an input, it will simply available at the CPU or internal bus. After that, if we are considering CPU wants to write either 0, either 1 as an output on the port pin. So here two conditions need to be analyzed. That is, first one, if CPU, that is here internal bus, wants to write 0, or CPU bus or internal bus wants to write 1 on the port pin. So here need to analyze the two conditions, whether we want to write 0 or we want to write 1 on the respective port pin. So while using this, initially internal bus needs to be assigned 0, that is that 0 signal is need to return on the port pin or transferred towards the port pin. So 0 is written on internal bus. Due to this 0 applied at flip-flop, so Q becomes 0, Q bar becomes 1. So Q becomes 0, Q bar becomes 1, and this 1 activates the lower FET, that is turns on the lower FET, and the signal available at lower FET, that is it will be connected to the ground. So low resistance path is followed, and due to this signal 0 volt is applied to the port pin. That is here VCC is also there, but due to again internal pull up resistors, it will not directly short circuited between VCC and ground. So at this junction or center point, when your lower FET turns on, it will simply carries the 0 volt signal or ground signal towards the port pin. So port pin is associated with 0 signal. So port pin is associated with 0 signal. If we want to transfer the 0, it will automatically transfer the 0 at port pin by turn on the lower FET. Here in case of output operations, read buffer, that is this, is not activated, that is control signal read pin is deactivated. So whatever signal is there, it will not transfer towards the internal bus. Okay, that's why if 0 is there, it will simply delivered at the output side, that is output pin of an port, that is here P1.0 or P1.1, whatever pin is there. So 0 will be transferred automatically when your lower FET turns on. So this is the condition for writing 0, and we need to check the next condition, that is write 1. Opposite to 0, we should think you have to deliver logic 1 or 5 volt supply to the output port pin. That is, it should be written initially at the internal bus, or 1 should be coming from the CPU side and it should be written on that internal bus. So when 1 is applied to the latch circuit, it will generate 1 to the Q and generates 0 to the Q bar. Due to this, your lower FET turns off. If it is initially on, then it will turns off, and connectivity is cutted from the port pin. So after that, whatever the signal is coming from VCC and through the load resistance, okay, so this signal is applied to the port pin. So in this case, again, your this buffer, read buffer or input buffer, tri-state buffer, is deactivated. So signal does not move in this direction, not possible. So after VCC, whatever signals are there, so this signal will be transferred towards the output pin, and that signal is considered as a high signal. So in this case, 3 volt to 5 volt, the signal dropped, and whatever the output signal provided to port pin is from 3 volt to 5 volt. So as per the selection of register bank, or simply if we consider the single register, then one register, that is value is having 1K, 2K, 5K, 10K, whatever. So as per the requirement, we have to select the load value, and according to that, we are able to access the signal, not equal or equivalent to the VCC, but the selection of register in such a way that we should avoid the direct short circuit between the VCC and ground when your lower FET turns on, that is at writing 0. So for this purpose, a sufficient value of resistance need to be selected to avoid the short circuit between VCC and ground. In this case, that is while writing 1, no problem, as your lower FET is turns off, so no connectivity between ground and VCC or signal coming after the internal pull-up resistor, so no connectivity is available. So it will simply deliver the signal towards the port pin. So this is related to the operation of an port 1, either as an input or as an output, and that to write 0, write 1. If you have any query, please ask query or doubt if you have any. Hello. Are you listening? Okay. Is it clear the working of port 1? Input port, how it is works, output, and that to write 0, write 1. Okay. So here, port 1 having only specific task, that is working as an input or output, not to additional task provided in port 0, like address oblique data bus. Okay, so this is related to only basic operation or mandatory operation of an port or port pins. So if it is clear port 1, then we will move towards the next port, that is port 2. Shall we move? They need to